emphasizing over the following aspects. First, the chapter is basically emphasizing over the following such of the aspects. First, economic conditions or economic activities. The types of the activities are the two. Types of activities are two. Economic and non-economic. Economic and non-economic activities. Economic activities which are helps to generate income. There are three categories of activities. Which generally a source of income of people in India. These are primary, secondary and tertiary. Primary, secondary and tertiary activities. Second, as the quality of population. The quality of a population has dependent upon, health and education. So in a field of health and education, what is the role of Government of India? How does the Government of India, it has improved the standard of health and education. And last, as the unemployment. Last, as the unemployment. What is unemployment and their different types? And how can we solve the problem of unemployment in India? So our chapter is basically emphasizing over the such aspects. Clear? So let's start this chapter, people as a resource. So workforce, total number of a population, all the population of a country, not even in India, in other countries, in all the countries of the world, population is a asset. Population is an asset, not a liability. Liability means as a burden. So population is not a burden on a government. It is as the assets. Because why we call population? Why we call population as the assets of country? Population which constitutes in a particular country as the assets. Because population contributes in economy. Population contributes in economy with production of goods and services. Those goods and services which are produced by humans because of their capabilities and efficiencies their value included, value means after selling, after providing such goods and services in economy, when they are selling in economy, it helps to generate income. It helps to generate income. And income indicates, income of a country indicates, income of a country, which is known as a national income, it indicates development of that particular country. Development of that particular country. Development of that particular country. World Bank classify world economies in three categories: developed economies. World Bank divided the world economies into three categories. First as developed economies. Second are developing economies. Third, underdeveloped economies. First, developed economies. Second, developing economies. Developing means as of which are now presently as improving their standards. Developing economies and underdeveloped economies. Underdeveloped economies. If we use the such classification of, given by the World Bank, our country India has lies under the underdeveloped. Our country India lies in underdeveloped economies. Reason why? Because due to low per capita income. This is also known as the average income. It is also known as the average income. Per capita income is also known as the average income. Average income means average person, whatever they earned in India, total income which has earned by the working class in India, working class which constitutes as the age group of 15 to 59 age group. Children under the 15 years and the elders, which are above our 60 years, retired persons, they are not producing goods and services, but we can't say these are the liabilities. These are not the liabilities because children under 15 age group, they are productive for nation. You kids are the productive for nation. Why we call you are productive? Because after some span of time, when you will qualified with the professional degree colleges, then you will able to produce goods and services. Goods and services. Services includes lawyers, teachers, doctors. These are the services. These are the services. And goods are generally produced in a form of agricultural goods and manufactured industries, industrial goods. Clear? That's why I marked earlier as the humans are the assets of country. Total population of a country is the assets. Now, how can we as calculate the per capita income? Per capita income, which criteria used by the World Bank to divide world economies as developed economies, developing economies, and underdeveloped economies. Per capita is average income earned by individuals, total individuals living in particular country. total individuals living in particular country. Particular country. It has calculated through total income. Total income earned from primary sector, secondary sector, and tertiary sector. Income earned from primary sector means farmer produce a crop. After the production, when they sell their surplus production, through which that income which earned by farmers. For example, farmers sold their wheat per quintal as the 2,000 rupees. So their value, 2,000 rupees. Same wheat used in a bakery for manufacturing of biscuits and bread. After selling of a bread, that baker, the owner of a bakery, it earned as the 6,000 rupees selling of a biscuit or bread. 2,000 plus 6,000. So for production in primary and secondary, primary sector and secondary sector means bakery, the type of the services availed by these two individuals, farmer or bakery owner. What kind of services like transport? They avail transport, they paid the toll tax. Toll tax. They're lending money from the banks. They paid the interest. Clear? So when there's such kind of the services which availed by the producers for the production, their value also added under the national income. So average income is calculated total income divided by total population. Total income earned from primary sector, secondary sector, tertiary sector divided by the total population, through which we can calculate the per capita income. Understood? Through which we can calculate the per capita income. So per capita income criteria used by the World Bank to divide world economies as developed economies, developing economies, and underdeveloped economies. And underdeveloped economies. So World Bank, when it categorized, so those countries where the average person earned as the 37,700 throughout the year. Ek saal mein, average person which has earned as 37,700 or it's less than, these are the developing economies. These are developing economies. India's per capita income is as the 27,000. Average person is earned as the 27,000 annually. 27,000 as annually. This is, that's why the India lies under the underdeveloped economies. Underdeveloped. That 27,000, it indicates that population which already earned in a millions and a billions. They are also the constitutes under it, because there is a smaller portion of a population is there which earned in a billions and in millions. But there is a large section of a population is there which still acts under poverty, which can't complete their basic needs of food, shelter, and clothing. There is a large section, 27% of a total population of India still under poverty, which can't complete their basic necessities. Food, shelter, and clothing. Food, shelter, and clothing. Yes, Ashmit? Till there any doubts? Ashmit?
Can you please repeat for how to calculate? Sir, how to calculate per capita income? Can you please repeat it?
Average income is earned from total income. Average income is generally calculated through the total income earned from primary sector, secondary sector, and tertiary sector divided by total population. Divided by total population, through which the per capita income or average income is generally calculates. Average income is generally calculates. So there is as a 27% of a population, 27% of a population in India is under poverty. Under poverty, which can't avail the two meals in a day. They are not having as a regular jobs. They are not having the regular jobs. Clear? In a year, limited number of jobs they are to which they earn. they includes as a beggar. They includes as a beggars. They are also the assets of the country. Assets. Indirectly, we can say as that these are the liability, but as the population, the total existing population, they are also playing as a role in economy. Role in economy. Due to the not doing the work in economy, the total average income has reduced in our country. Either we are talking about that there is a section that which earned the salaries in a five figures, six figures, in millions, in a billions, but still there are a people, some of the people are there which are not having the regular source of income. Regular source of income. So on this criteria, World Bank categorized these three economies. USA has lies in a developed economies. US, Canada, England, France, such countries, Russia, these are the developed economies. Japan, developed economies. Why? Because the per capita income in such countries, the average income in such countries has more than the 4,37,000. 4,37,000 above. They are having as a 4,37,000 rupees. This figure in rupees, 37,500. Their income, per capita income is a more. That's why they are the developed economies. In such economies, government capable to feed their population. If the population not doing the work, not produce the goods, they are not having the jobs, government having the resources through which they can feed them. Government can feed them. Agar koi kaam nahi kar raha hai, usko pension laga di jati hai. Government giving as a such money through which a person can sustain. Person can sustain. Second category as a developing economies, which now are still improving. Those economies which are improving, where the per capita income has lies in between of 37,700 to 37,700 to 4,37,700. 4,37,700. They are improving. They are overcome the problem of a poverty, unemployment. This problem is sorted out by the such economies. They are improving. So if we only use as a World Bank's criteria as a per capita income, then India has lies under underdeveloped. And the developing economies, their example, developing economies, its example, Sri Lanka. It's a developing economy. Sri Lanka, Indonesia, developing economy. Clear? These are the developing economies. But if we include the other kinds of the aspects, means the health status and literacy in a country. If we use a per capita income, health status and literacy, these three criteria, then we start to classify the world economies. World economies, this classification given by the HDI. The classification of world economies, another classification is there, which has given by the HDI, Human Development Index. Human Development Index. As according to this, India is lies under the developing countries. India lies in developing countries. Why? Because availability of a cheaper health facilities and high literacy rate, high education literacy rate in India makes India as a developing country. India is a developing country, not as the underdeveloped economy. Because the health status in our country, people coming from the foreign towards our country for the medical tourism, which you read in 7th standard, medical tourism. Because of availability of a cheaper health facilities and high literacy are every year, as an average every year, more than 4,000 engineers, doctors, professionally qualified individuals. These are moving towards a developed economies every year. Developed economies. I'm here not talking about those students which go towards Canada, England, and Russia after the completion of the plus two. No, those which are the qualified, professionally qualified doctors are there, MBBS doctors are there, engineers are there. After completion of their degrees, as an average, every year, more than 4,000, they are moving towards developed economies for their better future. Understood? So the, as per the classification of HDI, India lies in developing economies. In an economy, the total number of goods and services, their value used to calculate the GDP. Their value is used to calculate GDP. GDP stands for gross domestic product. Gross domestic product. So gross domestic product means sum value of goods and services produced in different sectors of economy. Clear? This is as the GDP. Presently, the GDP of our country is in negative. Reason, because of no production occurred during a time of a tenure of a lockdowns. Reduction in a production in industrial units, which led to the negative GDP in our country. GDP in negative in our country. There's one more term which is equivalent to the GDP is a GNP, gross national product, which are showing on your screens. Gross national product. This gross national product is generally calculates, GNP generally calculates GNP generally calculates GNP generally calculates so the highlighted portion in a red, gross national product, it generally calculates the sum value of goods and services produced in three sectors with addition to net income earned from abroad. Income which produced from three sectors in economy, primary sector, secondary sector, and tertiary sector. And income earned from abroad means those of the parents of the kids which move towards the foreign countries, fathers, they are living in other countries for the earnings. They earn in America, Canada, Dubai, UAE, but they're spending their money in our country. Because their families are in India, they are spending their financial resources in India. So with the calculation of a net income earned from abroad and income earned from three sectors, primary, secondary, and tertiary, is known as gross national product. Because such population is our asset. That population which has living now presently has moved towards other countries on temporary basis for the earning of their livelihoods. They are assets of India. Assets, why? Because they gain the education in India. After a qualification, they are producing the goods in other countries, but spending that money in our country. So through which we can calculate as the GNP, gross national product. Till there any doubts? Till there any doubts? Yes, Ashmit. Ashmit.
Sir, ek baar sir GNP ki definition repeat kar do.
Gross national product is the GNP stands for the gross national product, which calculates GNP calculates with some value of goods and services produced in primary sector, secondary sector, and tertiary sectors. Primary sector, secondary sector, and tertiary sector, with inclusion of net income earned from abroad. Total income, whatever which has earned from abroad, is include to which has we can calculate as GNP, gross national product. Here the GDP within a boundary of a country, whatever the goods and services are produced, domestic means within a boundaries of a country, those goods and services are produced is known as a GDP. And those goods which are earned, the income earned from abroad plus income earned within a territorial boundaries of a country is a GNP, gross national product. Clear, Ashmit? Gross national product, through which we can calculate as the GNP, gross national product. Gross national product. So let's we continue. So productive population is generally indicates the positive aspect of country. Positive aspect of country. Productive population. Productive, that population which engaged in a primary, secondary, and tertiary, they indicates as the positive aspect of a country. Because they contributes in national income. They helps to generate income. A person which earned, a farmer which sold their agriculture crop and earned salaries, earned income after the harvesting of their crop. After the harvesting of a crop, that income, that money, it's spent in to pay school fees of kids, means the fees which has deposited by the individual in schools is a source of a income of others. That money which has spent in a health services, that money which earned by the farmers after the harvesting of the crop, selling of the crop, afterwards that money it used by the farmer to protect their family from the health issues. Some amount of that money which earned through the harvesting and selling of a crop, it saved for the next year, for the emergencies, for the safeguard of their future, that money which deposited in a bank. So the officials which are doing the work in a banks, they are also earn the money to such income which earlier earned by the farmers. So income generates in a three sectors, it indicates as the positive aspect of economy. Positive aspect of economy. But there are some individuals, some kind of the workforce which are not producing goods and services, which are the liability. They are the liability. Those which are not contribute in a production activities, those which are not contributes in production activities are liabilities. They are a burden on economy. They are a burden on economy. Why? Because of such population, the average income influenced. Average income which has earned by the limited number of people, it has distributed, it has considered as a distribution among the such which are not producing anything in economy. And in developed economies of the world, they are emphasizing over to improve the health and education. They are basically contributes in improvements of health and education. There is one example, Japan. India is known for the natural resources. Natural resources are found in India. Agriculture is a possible. Minerals are existed in India. All different kind, categories of metallic, non-metallic, precious, all kinds of the minerals are there. But still, India is a developing country because of their population. As per the existing population, services are not improving. But as compared to this, when we take the example of Japan, in Japan, natural resources are not found. Agriculture is not possible because of the island country. Island country, Japan, agriculture is not possible. Minerals are not found in Japan. Every year, Japan, there is a threat of a tsunamis in every year. People, their life is affected by the tsunamis, but still Japan is a developed economy. This is as a developed economy. Why? Because Japan's 60% of a total budget. Budget is a procurement of a money for the next coming year. In our family's budget also the set by the family members, by your mother's budget. Ki kahan par kitna spend karna hai, kharcha karna hai, if there will be as a any of the emergencies, they also, mothers also procured some amount of money. So same as the country also make their budget. So 60% of the assets of a country, the money of country in Japan, it has spending on improving the health and education. They contributes in improving the health and education. But as compared to the Japan, in Pakistan, 70% of their total assets, they are basically emphasizing over military, management of military. That's why Pakistan as lagging behind, it is as an underdeveloped economy. Pakistan is an underdeveloped economy and Japan is a developed economy. Where due to the contribution in health and education, now the population is educated, it is as a healthy. If the population is healthy, well educated, then it will contribute as their 100% in production. Clear? It contributes as a fully for a production of goods and services. Such kind of a goods and services, it will be as a better in a quality because individuals, they contributed their efficiencies, capabilities for production of goods and services. Clear? So any doubts? Any doubts? Yes, Lavina.
Sir, GNP ka concept ek bar dobara explain kar do.
Gross national product, which has calculated as the sum value of goods and services, sum of all the goods and services which are produced in primary sector, secondary sector, and tertiary sector, with inclusion of net income earned from abroad. Income earned from abroad. Clear? So this much for today.